This is an original vintage poster from 1945, printed in Germany, advertising Bob Hope live for the USO. This poster was creased and stained, and we gave it a poster fix.
Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Posterfix Studio. Today is a very special day because we have a very rare poster that I've never seen in the shop before.
I got a group of World War II posters. One in particular is this one. Look at this. Right, Bob Hope. The Bob Hope Show, yeah. Friedberg, Germany, Saturday, 1945.
Yeah, so it's got folio folds, folio creases from being machine rolled from the printer, some rips in the folds, writing here, which I'd like to remove, and a tape stain. So at the back. The back looks clean, so I guess we're all set to go.
I'm going to prepare a screen for linen back in this poster.
I have this screen that's been stretched with cotton canvas, a nice canvas that's made in the USA. And then I take a big sheet of acid-free paper that's pre-cut to fit the canvas, and I cover it. I get it all wet. I get it all wet with water, and then I get it all wet with wheat paste. I cover it thoroughly with wheat paste. And then I lift up the paper, place it onto the canvas, roll out the paper so it's nice and snug to the canvas, and there I have it. I have a screen prepared for linen backing. Now we can put this poster down onto this paper and canvas.
I can put it this way or this way. Maybe I'll put it this way, save room. All right, Bob Hope's gonna get linen backed. It's in good shape, so I think I'll apply the wheat paste directly to the poster.
Okay, now I'm applying the wheat paste directly to the back of the poster. This wheat paste has an acid buffer added to it, plus a fungicide to kill bacteria. This poster is actually a German A1 format size poster, roughly 22 by 33 inches, printed in Germany for the American soldier audience. That's why it's in English. It's in two color, and I assume that this poster was printed in very small numbers. I'm spraying the poster, and I'm also giving it a few minutes to expand before I put another coat of wheat paste. As I wait and let it expand, I'm checking the back to see if there are any little bits of foreign objects or little bits of wood or some other foreign matter that could create a bump. And now it's time to put on the second coat of wheat paste. This will also ensure that the poster is completely stretched out, fully absorbed. Bob Hope. He was an actor, a singer, a dancer, and a comedian. And a USO icon. Bob Hope was many things, but to the USO and to the service members of the United States, he was the one-man morale machine. So I flip the poster around and I'm spraying it to help it expand more and become more pliable before I roll it out. Now, taking a roller, I'm going to gently roll out the air pockets between the poster and the paper, as well as pushing out the excess wheat paste. This will help the poster stretch out to its final position and get good and flat. This is from the USO.org website. Bob Hope dedicated much of his nearly 80-year career to entertaining American troops, both at home and abroad. Undeterred by enemy fire or rough seas, Bob Hope went straight to the front lines, delivering laughter, music, and, above all else, a reminder of home to our men and women in uniform, just when they needed it most. It stands to reason why this poster is in a German size format. The format's called A1. It measures roughly 22 by 33 inches. The poster was printed in Germany, but was in English because it's being used for the American soldier. And I'm sure these posters were printed in a very low print run since they were just used in a specific locality. Yet, it's beautiful design in two colors, and it's rolling out, stretching out extremely well. Now that the poster is all rolled out, it's time to take a couple of sponges and wipe it down clean. It's important to get all the wheat paste off the face of it so that when it dries, it doesn't have any funny streaks on it. Bob Hope's work with the USO in support of the US military paved the way for the many other entertainers who have followed in his footsteps. Bob Hope's legacy lives on at the USO, not only in the entertainment of the troops, but also in his unshakable belief in and dedication to expressing gratitude to America's service members for the sacrifices they make every day on behalf of this country.
Well, the Bob Hope Show has been linen-backed. Now it's got to dry before we do the restoration. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
We're back in the Posterfix shop. The poster has been linen-backed, and now we're going to start the restoration process of this vintage poster. Take a look.
Now that the screen is dry, we can commence with the work on this Bob Hope poster. With the restoration, that is.
My wife Oki is burnishing the poster to make it flatter. In addition to that, we are going to put in some paper fills so that I can touch it up once the poster is trimmed down. Bob Hope's career was dedicated to supporting the troops. Already an established comedian and actor by the onset of World War II, Bob Hope performed and broadcast his first USO show on the radio for service members on May 6, 1941, at an Army Air Corps, now known as the U.S. Air Force, base at March Field in Riverside, California. From that first show, Hope would go on to entertain the troops for nearly 50 years through World War II, the Korean War, the Vietnam War, the Lebanon Civil War, the Iran-Iraq War, and the Persian Gulf War. Now I'm using water-reversible gouache to do the touch-up on the stained areas and the paper fills. Bob Hope was one of the first major stars to join the USO in entertaining the troops during World War II, but he soon became the organization's most iconic USO tour veteran. Just 9 months after the United States entered World War II, Bob Hope embarked on the first ever USO tour by traveling to Alaska to entertain members of the armed forces. Soon after, Bob Hope began traveling overseas to visit troops in the European and Pacific theaters. Regardless of where he was going or how high the risks were, he often insisted on traveling straight to the front lines, even occasionally placing himself in harm's way in order to put on a variety show of comedy, singing, and dancing. His shows grew from a small comedy act to an ensemble of celebrity-studded televised programs. Special guests on his shows included the likes of Anne Margaret, Red Fox, Brooke Shields, Lola Falana, and more.
Hello, Jim.
Hello, Chris. How you doing?
Good.
Well, I've made it here. I'm down in the lobby, and I'm here to deliver those posters. Is there a room down here I could drop them off?
No, but I can come down if you want to wait in the lobby down there.
Well, that would be great. Okay. World War.
Go near the security guard area.
Yeah, I appreciate it. I appreciate it.
One of Bob Hope's most significant Christmas performances took place in Berlin in December of 1948, in which Hope and his USO troupe performed for troops supporting the Berlin airlift. It was this USO trip that inspired Bob Hope to begin his tradition of entertaining the military community during the holiday season. However, it was Hope and the USO's Bob Hope Christmas shows during the Vietnam War that truly solidified this tradition of holiday entertainment. During these iconic USO Christmas shows, in which Bob Hope would leave his own loved ones behind to be with the troops, service members deployed to far-off and unfamiliar places were able to enjoy a few hours of fun away from the battlefield. Bob Hope's last USO tour was in 1990, when he visited service members deployed to Bahrain and Saudi Arabia during the Operation Desert Shield. Although comedy and the U.S. military had changed a great deal since the first show in 1941, Bob Hope was still delighted to do what he did best, bring laughter to service members just when they needed it most. Well, this brings us to the end of Posterfix Studio for today. I want to thank you for joining me, and I'll see you next time.